What's going on, guys? Blake Hawthorne, it's His Turf. Tonight, we're going to be talking about landing new clients and upselling the ones you have. Welcome, guys, to Lawn Care Tips and Tricks. In tonight's video, we're talking about landing new leads. These are new clients. What I mean by this is not ever prejudging or ruling anybody out and constantly landing contacts that could be potential clients in the future, whether it's today, tomorrow, or next year. You never know. Constantly be making that connection and landing that lead. The next thing we're going to talk about is upsells with existing clients. Upsells in the industry sounds like a derogatory term, but we're going to focus on more of the education of your customers, not only on the services that you're providing, but also the ways that the customer can increase the value of their property and their curb appeal. This is with every single person you come in contact with. To me, everybody that I come in contact with is a potential client. This is somebody that I could do some type of service for, whether it's, you know, lawn maintenance, fertilization, weed control, sprinkler services, landscape services, hardscape, whatever it is. I'm always thinking there's something that I can offer to this person. So I need to make and land this contact and that make that impression with them so that they remember me whenever they go to do those services. So a lot of times that means just in casual conversation, letting them know what I do, showing them some pictures of stuff that we do, but then getting either one, you know, my business card, two, one of these cool bracelets that we now carry. I'll literally give them the one off my hand and just say, hey, go check out our YouTube, go check out our Facebook, go check out our Instagram. And then also following up, friending them to Facebook, because that's a good place that I use to land our clients, and then inviting them to like my business page. This is usually done within the first, you know, 24 to 48 hours of meeting that person, and it's a great way to be able to reel them in and let them to start to see your contact, because they're not always, whether they have your card or your bracelet or just taking your word, going to go and check those things out. So you kind of need that little nudge to get them there. Not about selling to them right away. You just want them to get to thinking about, hey, this is what this guy does. And like I said, whether it's today, tomorrow, next week, or next year, when they think about it, hopefully they think about you. The next thing is going to be not ruling any of these people out. Like I said, it's every person you come in contact with. So don't prejudge or, you know, just kind of get your own thoughts and ideas like, oh, well, this person has somebody or this or that. You never know when somebody's gonna screw up. You're never gonna know when somebody may get tired of doing it themselves or when they have some bigger project that they're gonna want you to do because of the person you are, your integrity, and how they like you as a person and a company. As far as upsells, there's a lot of ways that you can do this. I personally think that you should just continue to educate your customers. Now, guys, this means either one, looking at the property, analyzing what they need done, and bringing it to their attention, whether it's grass that needs to be replaced, maybe it's a section that needs to be dethatched, or it's a dry spot in the summer that needs irrigation done, an area that you could spruce it up with some new plantings or some annual flowers, just different things that you can do, and constantly listening to the customer if they have any type of problems or concerns. Those are giving you an opportunity to step up as the professional and to lead and guide them into what they need to do for their property. All customers are looking for that opportunity to be able to, one, increase the value of their property, or two, just to have the nicest yard on the block to have that curb appeal. If you're already there doing services, look for those opportunities of upsell. Early on, as we got into this, we expanded our services, guys. I added it to my Facebook page. I even added it to my door hangers, all the list of the services we were doing. And then I went as far as making this, you know, this brochure. The brochure goes in, it's got a lot of really nice pictures and everything. And I sent one of these out to all of my customers. But what do you know? A lot of them never even looked at it. And so it came down to me physically telling them, hey, you know, we offer these other services in case you need anything. As we're coming up on winter, I would say, hey, we offer 20% off for fall and winter services on any landscape and hardscape installations. These are things that we could do outside of their routine lawn maintenance. But then, guys, it was also finding customers that, one, we were doing landscaping for and trying to pick them up for lawn care. Or if we were doing lawn care for them, trying to let them know about the landscape and hardscape services. I was trying to get every single client the opportunity, if they wanted to go to us for all the services, you know, one company to do everything on their property, that they had that opportunity, but they also knew that we were capable of doing it. And then I built the team behind me to be able to do that as well. So whether you're a one-man show and you can focus and specialize on all of that, guys, or if you're a company that has different crews that focus on those different areas. You just need to educate your customers, letting them know what you do, what new services you may have added that you didn't have last year, and then opportunities at a percentage off to have you do it. I think that's a great thing that we've done to keep us busy through the wintertime, is to let our customers know, all of our customers know, that we offer these other services at a discounted rate through the winter, just so that we can stay busy as a company and that it does expire March 1st, because that's when we start prepping and getting ready for spring. So guys, I hope this is a way not only that you can start to continue to build leads, to grow your clientele. It's a great way that we grew to over 2,000 clients in just over 5 years, that I think that if you'll start to just be very intentional with, that you can do the same thing. And then also how you can grow and expand your crews and your services by focusing and educating your customers on things that they need. Don't always focus on the selling, focus on the educating. And I think that you'll see a lot better results. So guys, thank you so much. God bless. We'll see you next time here on Lawn Care Tips and Tricks.